All right, time now to talk business. And for that, we welcome in our business editor, Mike Eppel. Hi, Mike. Very, very busy morning. Let's start by talking jobs.
The bad news out of the way first, I suppose, Sarah, because these numbers for the month of March were record-breaking by pretty much every metric. Stats Canada tabulating how many Canadians lost work last month, and they did the survey a little bit later than they typically would during a month. So they started on March 15th, sort of on the cusp of the economic shutdown, went for a week, and from their tabulation, more than 1 million Canadians were unemployed through the month of March, and that exceeded the previous monthly record tenfold. Back in 1997, the economy lost just over 100,000 jobs in a single month. The unemployment rate up to 7.8%. We look on a provincial basis, and Alberta lost 117,000 jobs, which was another major hit to the economy. Energy sector, obviously, extremely hard hit, but every sector is being hit at this point. And this is why the feds have ponied up so much cash, you know, these checks going out to help pay the monthly bills for those who are finding themselves out of work.
But on the other side of things, WestJet announcing that they, too, are going to be rehiring some of their employees.
Yeah, 6,500 or thereabouts, maybe more. But the CEO, Ed Sims, saying that, look, these people aren't going to be working, per se, because WestJet's flights are grounded. For the most part, all of them internationally, many of them across the country. But this is the company tapping into that Ottawa plan to pony up, 75% of employees' salaries. As Air Canada announced yesterday as well, it's going to tap into that program, which still needs to be approved. But they got to recall Parliament here, at least briefly, to get this actually going. So this has been the big problem. You know, it's still 3 to 6 weeks away. So for small business specifically, which don't have the financial depth to weather this storm, they're hurting harder than certainly the big companies. Nevertheless, some of the big companies rehiring laid off staff.
What's happening this morning with OPEC? Are we talking deal or no deal?
It's Seinfeldian. They want to reach an agreement, but can they actually reach an agreement on a production cut? Russia says they're in. They're talking. Do they cut output? We will see. G20 energy ministers are meeting tomorrow, and I should mention, Sarah, that the markets this morning are on fire again because the central bank in the United States has opened the spigot again to shower with cash, a $2.3 trillion lending program, which has the Dow already up 500 points this morning. This week, the Dow, the blue chip indicator for Wall Street, up more than 2,800 points over 4 days. That's more than 10%. That is remarkable. So if you've got an RRSP, you know, you're in the market, you've seen at the worst of it, March 23rd was the low. Since then, we're up about 25%, if not more. So feel a little bit better about that, at least, going into a long weekend and happy Easter as well.
Yes, with that, I hope you enjoy Easter with your family, and we'll see you next week.
Okay.
All right. You can hear more from Mike Eppel on 660 News. In the meantime, though, let's go ahead and take a look at the markets and what's to come here on Breakfast Television.
This portion of BT is brought to you by 660 News, Calgary's breaking news, weather, and traffic station.